Zbawcy do swojego Syna i objawiłeś mi Jego jako król nad królami. A oni wierzyli w Niego, dali mu pokój i złożyli dar. Bogosław te krew dla oznaczenia drzwi naszych mieszkań, których przyjęliśmy światło Twojego objawienia. Spraw, abyśmy się stawali coraz bardziej wyłącznym światłem dla ludzi, którzy Ciebie szukają. Pobłogosław też kadzidło, aby jego wolny dym wznosił się wraz z naszymi modlitwami przed Twoje oblicze. Spraw, jak nasze domy będę mieszkańcem codziennej modlitwy w jedności z Twoim Synem, który zamieszka między nami, aby objawiać nam Ciebie, który z Tobą żyje i króluje.
your only begotten Son to the nations by the guidance of a star. Grant in your mercy that we, who know you already by faith, may be brought to behold the beauty of your sublime glory. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Czyli objawienie się Jezusa w świat. Bo są spot gives you a song to represent the land of the Savage. Shisky gives you a few times. But it is a savage as a bit of shadow work. It had a ravish not more to net with it. That one you check the fishing. Because you check it by the grease of blood. Yet up young, and crumbled the eight young. Gives you the edge of the gas. But it's a insect in the bit of shame.
Manifestation, as we mentioned in the
opening remarks of today's Mass, a relatively private event of Christmas symbolically manifested in the world through the rise of the Magi. Kings, wise men, whatever we refer to them as, people of the different races and different parts of the world, the universality of God's gift of salvation is represented through them. They found a star, which in the ancient world, the oracle of important tidings and important events. Now what's funny is, they follow from far away and come to the land of Bethlehem, where there are scholars and priests of the law who recognize the star, have no knowledge. It does not affect their life. It takes the people from afar to come and point it out to them. Then all of a sudden, there's the vast tract and here in 12% of the story is familiar to us. So on the one hand, we have the people from afar, three pagans, pointing out what's written under the nose of the people who are supposed to be the recipients of that. What's the result? Well, they're able to only conjure up for everybody the words of prophecy, but not an interpretation of the meaning. The wise men went home, converted, and the ones who are right under the star are changed. How often in our own world it takes something outside of ourselves to point out the reality that's there all along. Sort of like you can't see the forest through the trees, and yet it happens in the spiritual life too. Going to Bethlehem, the wise men find the baby Jesus, and they offer him some obvious gold, frankincense, myrrh, gold to the king, incense to the true God, and myrrh in symbol of his burial. And in memory of this, the church throughout history has blessed all three of those elements. Along the way, it has added the creature chalk, as the blessing says in Latin. To do what? To bring this important manifestation out of the privacy of the church and into our own homes. So, by our prayer display, we have the blessed chalk, we have the prayers in English and Polish for the blessing of the homes. And we usually mark the symbols of above the door, the New Year's, in this case 20 and then 21, and then in between with crosses, the symbols C or in Polish K, M and B. Those are two traditions for that. One says they are symbolic and traditional names of the Magi, Caspar, Melchior, and Balthasar. And yet in Latin, they form an acronym. An acronym like CEO, Chief Executive Officer, FBI, Federal Bureau of Investigation. Well, CMB is Christus Mansion Benedicta, which means may Christ bless this. So every time we go in, every time we go out above the principal door, we see a reminder that the private event of Christmas is not supposed to be private and kept locked up in the church, but the true church is the church of home, and the presence of Jesus is supposed to really be in our lives in that very special place. The gospel makes the point at its conclusion of saying that the Magi were more than a dreamer, that they should not return. So they went home by another route. This has always been interpreted by the church as what happens when someone encounters Jesus. You're transformed. You no longer see things in the same way, and therefore you no longer act in the same way. So of course the Magi will go home by another route, because they see the world differently. Things are not as they were before. That's the transformational effect of Jesus in our lives. And it's true today, as much as it was true back then for them. The German cardinal Joachim Meister wrote that what God whispered into the ears of the world at Christmas, Epiphany wants us to shout from the rooftops to the whole world. And that is the same gift that Jesus comes to give to everyone. But when saying it is a gift to everyone, we have to remember a very important distinction. We are included in that number. It's not everyone nameless, faceless out there. It's everyone known to God with a face and includes us here. Because ultimately, the Christian vocation is to what? To walk the road with Jesus. So when we encounter him, we are transformed. And because our lives are transformed, we help to transform the world into what? Into a reflection of God's kingdom, which is exactly what we pray every time we say the Lord's Prayer. Thy kingdom come on earth as it is in heaven. We're not waiting for God to create new and better and more things. God's already created them. He's also created us. And our job is to help the process of transformation. Amen.
Let us now stand and together profess our faith. Today we will recite it in Polish. Wierzę w jednego Boga, Ojca Wszechmogącego, Stworzyciela nieba i ziemi, wszystkich rzeczy widzialnych i niewidzialnych, i w jednego Pana Jezusa Chrystusa, Syna Bożego Jednorodzonego, który z Ojcem jest zrodzony przed wszystkimi wiekami. Bóg z Boga, światłości, światłości, Bóg prawdziwy z Boga prawdziwego, zrodzony, a nie stworzony, współistotny Ojcu, a przez Niego wszystko się stało. On to dla nas ludzi, dla naszego zbawienia, wstąpił z nieba. I za sprawą Ducha Świętego przyjął ciało z Maryjczynicy i stał się człowiekiem. Ukrzyżowany również za nas, pod Poncjuszem Piłatem, został umieszczony i pogrzebany. I zmartwychwstał dnia trzeciego, jak oznajmie Pismo. I stąpił do nieba, siedzi po prawicy Ojca. I powtórnie przyjdzie chwałę, sądzi żywych i umarłych, a królestwo Jego nie będzie końca. Wierzę w Ducha Świętego, Pana i Ożywiciela, który od Ojca i Syna pochodzi, który z Ojcem i Synem wspólnie opiera uwielbieniem i chwałą, który mówił przez proroków. Wierzę w jeden święty powszechny apostolski Kościół, wyznaję jeden chrzest na odpuszczenie grzechów i oczekuję wskrzeszenia umarłych i życia wiecznego w przyszłym świecie. Amen.
Like the wise men who follow the star in faith to discover the newborn Savior of the world, we too not walk with faith to present before our Lord our needs and our petitions.
Thank you. Thank you.
Therefore, most merciful Father, we make humble prayer and petition through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, that you accept and bless these gifts, these offerings, these holy and unblemished sacrifices, which we offer you firstly for your holy Catholic Church. Be pleased to grant her peace, to guard, unite, and govern her throughout the whole world. Together with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Edward, our Bishop, and all those who hold it to the truth, hand on the Catholic and Apostolic faith. Remember, Lord, your servants living and all gathered here whose faith and devotion are known to you. For them we offer you this sacrifice of praise, or they offer it for themselves and all who are dear to them, for the redemption of their souls, in hope of health and well-being, and paying their homage to you, the eternal God, living and true. Celebrating the most sacred day on which the only begotten Son, eternal with you in your glory, appeared in a human body, truly sharing our flesh, and in communion with those whose memory we venerate, especially the glorious ever-Virgin Mary, Mother of our God and Lord Jesus Christ, and Blessed Joseph, her spouse, your blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul, Andrew, and all your saints, we ask that through their merits and prayers in all things, we may be defended by your protecting help. Therefore, Lord, we pray, graciously accept this oblation of our service, that of your whole family. Order our days in your peace, and command that we be delivered from eternal damnation, counted among the flock of those you have chosen. Be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect. Make it spiritual and acceptable, so that it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands, and with eyes raised to heaven to you, O God, his almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands, and once more giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Pamiętaj, Boże, o swoich sługach i służebnicach, którzy przed nami odeszli znakiem wiary i śpią pokoju. Bo
ograniczeń najtym zmarł oraz wszystkim spoczywającym w Chrystusie udział Twojej światłości, radości i pokoju. Również nam, Twoim grzesznym sługom, ufającym z Twojej wielkiej miłosierdzie, daj udział we wspólnocie z Twoimi świętymi apostołami i pięcznikami, Janem Szczycielem, Szczepanem, Maciejem, Barnobą, Kazimierzą i wszystkimi Twoimi świętymi. Prosimy Cię, dopuść nas do ich gronu, lecz z powodu naszych zasług, i lecz dzięki Twojemu przebaczeniu przez Chrystusa, naszego Pana, przez którego Boże wszystkie te dobre ustawicznie stwarzać, uświęcać, ożywiać, błogosławić i ich udzielać. Przez Chrystusa, z Chrystusem i Chrystusie, Tobie, Boże Ojcze Wszechmogący, w jedności Ducha Świętego, wszelka cześć i chwała przez wszystkie wieki wieku.
Thank you. the body of Christ. The body of Christ.
Amen.
The body of Christ.
Our prayer to St. Rocco. O great St. Rocco, deliver us, we beseech thee, from the scourges of God. Through thy intercession, preserve our bodies from contagious diseases and our souls from the contagion of sin. Obtain for us salubrious air, but above all, purity of heart. Assist us to make good use of health, to bear suffering with patience, and after thy example to live in the practice of penance and charity, that we may one day enjoy the happiness which thou hast merited by thy virtues. St. Rocco, pray for us that we may be preserved from all diseases of body and soul. St. Marco, pray for us that we may be preserved from all diseases of body and soul. St. Marco, pray for us that we may be preserved from all diseases of body and soul. Wood Mission. Bože, któryś błogosławionemu Romowi przez anioła swego przyobieca, że każdy pobożny go wywający od wszelkiego morowego powietrza wolnym zostanie. Daj nam, prosimy Ciebie, aby którzy Jego pamiątkę nabożnie obchodzili mocą zasług Jego, od śmiertelnego powietrza ciało i duszy mieli zachowane. Przez Pana naszego Jezusa Chrystusa, który z Tobą żyje i króluje, Bóg na wieki wieków. Just one announcement, well, two actually. First, thanks to everyone for joining us on this great Feast of Epiphany. It may come as a surprise to you, but this is the third highest ranking feast in the Church's calendar. The first is Easter, the second is Pentecost, and before Christmas itself is today, Epiphany. Because remember what we said, Christmas, while it's important, was a relatively private event. Today, the message of Christmas is made known to us all. And also, immediately following Mass, it's good to see our parishioner Mitch Pena back up and about and with us. And Mitch also serves as the District 5 Director for the Polish Roman Catholic Union of America. He has a box of goodies from the PRCUA, and anyone who'd like to receive one, please just come up after Mass and he'll hand you the envelope and the goodies that we have from our friends in Chicago, who, by the way, were kind enough to furnish to our parish the Polish-English calendars with the Wiczynianki motif that we were able to pass out for this new year. So thank you for being here, Mitch, and thanks for your help with that as well.
Let us pray.
Go before us with heavenly light, O Lord, always and everywhere, that we may perceive with clear sight and revere with true affection the mystery in which you have willed us to participate through Christ our Lord.
Amen.